All right. Captions are working. Yes, captions are finally working. Oh god. But we're using my USB mic because I don't want to get dye on my delicious Rode microphone. So that's going away. So we're using the USB mic because I can be anywhere and not have to be all up in it. Hi lovely friends. How are you today? I'm alive. I was having a great day, and then I started thinking too much. And now I'm stuck in an overactive thought loop. And it's not fun. It's really, really not fun. Okay, wait, I think I have to turn the music down a bit. There we go. That's probably better. Yeah. I don't know. My face, just like, since, I don't know if it's an allergic reaction to the chlorine or what's going on, but I've been like, I'm just like, my skin looks so, like I have like red freckles. I don't know what it is, but I'm like super self-conscious about it right now. So I'm like, I don't want to be on camera. My camera literally picks up every pixel of every pore of my face. So I'm like, maybe I should just get a shittier camera. Maybe I should get a different lens that isn't so accurate. So I don't have to be like staring at my face. It might be rosacea. I don't know. I've always had like these rosy red cheeks, and I'm like trying to embrace it, you know? It's like I get free blush. You know, some people have to put on blush, like I just have free blush. But for me, it's like now it's like specifically spots. Like it's like freckly red spots. It's not acne, it's just spots. I don't know. But it could be because like I'm trying a new skincare routine and my skin doesn't like niacinamide or something. I'm like trying to make my skin better and it's just making it angry. Freckles are in, except it's red freckles. They're not actual freckles, they're just red spots. I don't know. I think it might just be my system is overwhelmed or something. I've been sweating a lot because I'm going to the gym and swimming and like all sorts of weird things are happening to my body, so it makes sense that my skin is like eep. But still, oh my, what? I don't know if the audio is like okay right now, but hey, look, there's room to dance now. Whoa! Oh my god! Oh my god! We'll be right back. I missed this space. I missed who I was. I don't know. Good times. Thank you for the $100. We're back. We do have the unicorn mask too. Though I will advise you, if you want me to use it, it's gotta be now.
I've been feeling blonded. I don't know. Like rainbow nose is death the vibe, but also blonde nose just works somehow.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you so much. So the unicorn mask too. Yeah, that can happen, but if I have hair dye on, I am not putting that thing on my head, as you see. Thank you. That was actually I think my donut goal is missing, but that was literally my donut goal for today was my internet bill, which is $100-something, so you just smashed my donut goal.
You just...
Oh, it's there somewhere. What the fuck? I don't even know what's going on. Transform. Yep. I don't know. It's invisible right now. But anyways, we're hanging out. Welcome. Thank you for paying my internet bill. I should probably talk to them and see about getting it reduced now that there's not two streamers living in the house. I don't really need an insane amount of speed. The reason my internet's so expensive is because we were, like, paying for two people to stream at the same time. So, I don't know. How am I doing? I'm all over the place. I could try to cut back the bill. I don't know if they're gonna let me. I feel like everything that has a subscription is trying to charge more and more and more and more and more and more, more. So I'm like, well, shit. No wonder people are canceling all the subscriptions. Yeah, welcome back. Welcome back to the chaos, the beautiful chaos. This is where we were intended to be. I couldn't have left this spot for long. This is the place. This is the stream room. We built this city on Twitch TV. Cyber Monday. For what? What are we talking about? What was I gonna buy? Was I gonna buy stuff? Like, to upgrade the stream room, I would need new speakers for sure. That's the first order of business. But oh, internet. That's what we were talking about. Okay. Yep. Interesting idea. Interesting concept. We'll consider. I need to have rainbow hair. Like, I need to have it as in yesterday. My brain hurts for being blonde for so long. Because I freaking lose all my confidence. I don't know where my combs went. Everything is so chaotic right now. Like, I've been moving my studio back and forth and back and forth since my old roommate moved out. Trying to figure out what configuration works, and now I'm just scatterbrains. Yeah, well, I really like Rogers. Like, I like the deal that I'm with. I just want to make it less. They're gonna be good until they start gouging again, right? Yeah, so I'll talk to them. I'll be like, hey guys, so I would like to downgrade. See what they say about that. But actually, damn, okay, yeah, right? Right, Erd? It's definitely different. It's been a vibe. It works for sure because, like, my natural hair when I was a kid. When I was a baby, when I was, like, 1 to 2 years old, my hair was this color. I shit you not. My hair was platinum blonde as a baby. So that's why it works. But now, now that I'm aging, my hair is more, it's like, you can see my roots. It looks very dark in comparison, but if it grows out all the way, it's actually just like a light brown. But yeah, I've got a clean canvas to work with. So all of this gets to be rainbowified. What is this? What is this piece? Oh my goodness. It's gonna be tricky though, because there's so many layers. Usually I can section my hair off, but the way that this cut is done, it's so many layers that they're all very, like, blended in with each other. Feels very Kesha. I'm here for it. I feel like it's giving mentally unstable person, has no control over their life, so instead they're just trying to find peace by destroying their hair. instead of destroying themselves. That's pretty much what's happening. That's what you're witnessing right now. it's a beautiful kind of chaos, you know? So I'm happy to see both my lady mods here. Hello, M. Hello, Kagome. Thanks, Photon. It's good to see you too. Happy Sunday. AKA Bangs. Yes, this is the... We're... Like, it was instant regret. Instant regret. I knew. Like, this is... Listen. Coming up in January, you know, I had one relapse. But aside from that, it's been... What year is it? 2023? Yeah, this January will be 4 years free of self-harm with one relapse. So, this is the closest thing I could do, I guess, is just destroy my hair. Something, part of me wanted to just do bangs and just like, fuck it! We're gonna get bangs. And now I'm like, oh no. But merms, no. Why? it's gonna look good with color, but like, just having gone through the bangs phase, like, this is very much, this is the younger me. Like, when I was younger, when I first started dyeing my hair all the time, like 17, 18, 19, I had bangs all the time, because I cut my own hair, and I was just like, yeah, like, I couldn't stop, and I don't know, you guys have noticed my eyebrows are also gone too, like, got a little bit of a trichotillomania problem, so, I am beating myself up over it, it's literally my mental disorder, so, we're gonna fix it all with hair dye now, it made me feel magical about myself again, yay! I also need to stop touching my face. I think that's also why I have so many red spots, is like, I noticed I've been touching my face a lot lately. Not ideal. Okay. We got a big old bag of tricks right over here. You have trichotillomania too, right? It's not fun. But it's a thing. We have so much blue. We could just do this whole thing blue and I would be happy. I just need to see colors. I like to do guitar and sing at the same time. Have you been to my streams? Yeah. That's literally all that I do. I actually play guitar and sing and play violin and play trumpet and piano at the same time. While DJing with my feet. You just gotta be around more often, my friend. We've got lots of blue. This is also a nice blue. There's my pinky poo. We also had that Arctic Fox. This was like a new color. Wrath. Oh, I didn't open it yet. Not sure what color this actually is gonna be, though. Oh, wow. That's a very red. Like, it looks a little bit orangey on the camera, but for my eyes, without the camera's filter. Don't tempt me. It's like a fresh bottle, too. Oh my god. It's not enough for my whole hair, though. That's a thing. I haven't had red hair since I was 13. Like, when I was 13, it went fully red. Okay. Usually I go for cool tones, right? I go for like the blues, greens, and like soft pinks, stuff like that. But red and black? No, I can't. I can't. I'm gonna hate it again. I'm gonna be like, who are you? Why are you changing so much? But I do have a lot of black. The problem is that I know. No, I was gonna do a black streak. I'm gonna do a black streak somewhere. At some point. It's giving Belia. Oh my god. The red. My rat tails. Well, no, I was gonna do the stripies. Stripies back here. But I know how good. So I did like a blue red. It was crazy. It looked so good. I also have my mirror down here. That should probably go up on my desk. Seems pretty even. Black polka dots, girl! You trying to fuck my hair up? No, we're not doing polka dot hair. That's ridiculous. Get your mind out of the gutter. This red is really fucking gorgeous, though. The poison? Poison is more... Whoa, that's also really red. Wrath has more of a magenta tone to it. I would love to see how that fades out, though. It's the color of, like, cranberries. Oh my goodness. Just draw a penis on your hair. You're so supportive. The split blue and red. Yeah, that's kind of what I'm feeling, but I also know I have a symmetry thing happening now, so I have to think about that. And I also have, like, layers for days. So I'm like, should I do an ombre, or should I just, like, split? I should split dye. Oh my god, I need a split dye, don't I? Fuck. Oh my god, you did that! You're nuts. I don't know. So that's just it. Like, I don't know. I could do anything. The possibilities are endless. I really like that red, though. It was definitely giving. Okay. This is why it took me so long to even get to stream. I'm like, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna figure it out. I wish I had a plan. I do not have a plan. But we're doing it live, so. I think I kind of know what I want to do. I'm probably going to start with the bang pieces because that went down the wrong pipe. Because they are the most importante. Also, I need paper towel. Where did my paper towel go? There is definitely going to be some spills today. Okay. And the tinfoil, where did it? Okay, it's over here. Good, 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 good. All right. You're scared because you've never gotten more than highlights. What are you getting your hair done? What are you doing to it? I mean, at the end of the day, don't be scared. It's literally hair. It's literally just hair. You grow it for free. It just grows off of your body constantly. You will be fine. It will grow back. That's kind of why I've been testing myself, I think. Because I'm like, I have to just trust fall with my own hair. I'm just like trusting, you know, it's like, okay, I'm allowed to make mistakes because it's hair. It's not gonna just like jump off my body. It's gonna be here and it'll grow back eventually. All right. Yeah, how many times do you watch me dye my hair and you're scared of a professional? Exactly. I am no professional. I am just a creative type with way too many mental disorders and not enough money. That is why I dye my hair. I don't know. It's also like a control thing for sure for me. It's a taking my power back kind of moment. Being like, I can do whatever the fuck I want with my hair. This is my hair. And it really started in high school. And I also went to a uniform school for a long time. And it's like, you have to wear these exact clothes. And I'm like, well, you can't make me cut my hair off. So and that's when I started dyeing my hair all fucking crazy shit. What am I drinking? My partner left some of these in the fridge. So I was just like, it's like soda water with a tiny bit of alcohol in it. It's mango flavored. It's basically bubbly mango water with a hint of vodka. Just a hint, you know? Just a little wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Okay. Purple, people. Purple, blue. Oh, this one's not open. So how about that's open? Hello? Siren song. Is that the right color? Mermaid. This is my color. Atomic turquoise. The best blue in the world. And then this one looks a bit oxidized. I don't know about that one. Yeah, this one's a bit better. That one I may need to throw out. Okay. You're bald. Okay, well, then you can live vicariously through me. How's that sound? Is the music really quiet? Can I turn it up a little bit? Here. You texted me. Okay, well, I'm not going to be able to answer texts right now because I'm strimming. Yeah. Sorry, I didn't notice because, like, it was supposed to be quiet.
Oh.
Oh, my God. Okay. I feel like, actually, I have to do the bangs first before anything, because like they're the centerpiece, right? And I was gonna do a full rainbow. I don't know how I'm gonna do that. Just making sure all these dyes are still good because I opened them so long ago. It's been like fucking like 6 months. Yellow. And I got a confession. Let's see if it'll come out this way. There we go. Alright, in before I dye my entire forehead. Is this gonna work? No, I don't think so. We're just gonna do it live. We're literally just gonna do it live. Okay, this is the part where I need my mirror though. So I'm gonna put this here. Shift a few things around. Yes, I will coconut oil. Coconut oils, that's a good point. Coconuts make the oil not stick to your face. Create a protective barrier while moisturizing your skin. My stupid skin, which already hates me enough. Hates me so much right now. I'm gonna be so greasy after this. Some people use Vaseline and I'm like, are you okay? You putting that much Vaseline on your skin? At least coconut oil kind of absorbs. Who's Bill O'Reilly? Am I missing a reference here? Am I too young for that? Alright guys, we're on a time crunch. I have an hour to do this. An hour to dye my entire hair. Because I have a friend coming over at 8. To help me out with some cleaning stuff and renovations. Which are still undergoing. Like, I have so much shit to fucking do. It's nuts. Moving the studio and then moving it back? Why? I literally just lost like a week of my life just moving stuff around because I'm neurotic. Trying to find a peace of mind in my own home. Hello, Euronimo. Went on a fine life, he just couldn't do it in rehearsal. Okay. Okay, maybe I'll look into it, or I don't know. You can find it on Discord, but... We'll probably do the Discord hang this week. As I mentioned, like, I'm still renovating everything. I might be getting some foster cats. So I think the next music stream won't be until, like, Friday again. Like, it'll be a week. Because I also have a gig on Saturday that I have to prepare for, and I've got to get all my music gear set up in this room, and it's gonna take a hot minute to get everything kind of set up. Yeah. Foster cats. Yeah, I might be fostering cats, like Claire Pix. And I'm taking a page out of Claire Pix book. Goody Ink. What am I doing? Just losing my mind. What about you? How are you? Do you want to join me? I have this giant mirror here that's gonna break my monitor, probably. Oh no. It's a rotate. Oh god, my PC tower. There we go. That's reasonable. How many? 100 million cats? No, probably just one. Probably just one to start and see how it goes, and especially with my allergies, like, notice if I am dying, and then if I am dying, stop dying, probably, would be a good advice. Going in hot. Do not try this at home, folks, unless you have very large balls or a very large clitoris, whatever you prefer. Very large gonads. Because once you do this, your life will never be the same. I feel like, you know when you start writing, like, font, and you'll, like, write a word, but then you run out of space at the end so everything gets all squished? I'm trying not to do that with the coloring right now. I'm trying to do the full Roy Gabov. You know what I mean? The full rainbow. But we gotta blend it. Oh my goodness. My bangs are gonna be so gay. Oh my god. Somehow I need to condense all of this into like a small reel so I can actually post to social media. I suck at editing videos though. Okay. Yeah, goody. Are you down? You wanna lose your minds together? It'll be fun, I promise. Forehead. I kind of saw that coming though. Okay. Every PowerPoint. I miss PowerPoint. I think Microsoft Office should be free. And you want to know why? Because Gen Z has no idea what the fuck they're doing. And ChatGPT is pretty free, I'm sure, right? Is ChatGPT free? And I'm like, if you didn't make kids pay $70 just to fucking type on a computer, then maybe they would be more inclined to do so. Oh my god. These are gonna be the gayest bangs you've ever fucking seen in your life. And it's not gonna matter that my forehead is dyed because the bangs are gonna cover it up, actually. This is content. This is content right here. What you're watching is content. It's gonna be so gay. It's gonna be so gay that it verges on homophobic. Like, that's how gay. It's gonna go so gay that it's like goes backwards into homophobia. I'm gonna show up to the gay club and they're gonna be like, I'm sorry, you're too gay. We only accept mild gays. Okay. I actually did go to the- Did I tell you guys I went to the gay club? Because I wanted to support my friend's drag show. It was their drag-iversary. But then I was like, oh fuck, I forgot. I don't club. I hate clubs. I am an introvert who has social anxiety, and suddenly I'm surrounded by a bunch of like really young people. Like, I'm pretty sure most of those people were kids, like 19, 20. And that's when I realized, I'm like, oh my god, yeah, I forgot. Like, young people go to clubs. That's not a people in your older 20s thing. That's like a young 20s thing. And I was like, damn, 5 years ago. But then the pandemic happened. And I'm like, well, I just kind of enjoy a nice night in with a Uber Eats and a TV. I don't like the loud noises and the drinking makes me kind of, like, angry the next... Well, not angry, but, like, my body gets mad at me for drinking too much. So I don't like that too much. I can have a couple drinks. Like, I can have a drink or two, and I'm fine. But, like, going drinking for the sake of drinking? Used to be, you bounce back right away. Yeah, when you get old enough, you just don't care anymore. Yeah, it's not new and exciting. You can only go clubbing so many times before you're like, alright, alright. Okay, my ears hurt now. My feet hurt. My ears hurt. When are we going home? It loses its appeal. I don't know if it's your frontal lobe developing fully, or if it's just because you've done it enough times and it's just like, oh, well, I don't like that anymore. Just like when I was a kid. I'm like, how do kids eat so much fucking sugar? Like, I think about when I was a kid and I would spend all my allowance at the corner store and I would eat so much candy. And now I eat like 2 pieces of a fuzzy peach. And I'm like, oh my god, I have the worst bellyache ever. Please, end my suffering. You know? Oh shit, I ran out of Bang. I ran out of Bang! I didn't even get to the blue! Cocksucker. You used to love candy? I'm more into, like, I love baked goods now. I love, like, a chocolate mousse cake. Oh my god, we can't start talking about this because it's Sunday. How am I gonna get fucking chocolate mousse cake on a Sunday? Like, I literally need pastries now. Yeah, I'm into pastries. Pastries? Dude, tiramisu? Like, send me back to Paris. I was the happiest I've ever been in Paris. This year I went to Paris for TwitchCon. I shit you not, it was the happiest I've ever been in my entire life, was that week that I was in Paris. And I want to go back. I need to go back. Please let me go back. That's all I want, is to just be back in Paris forever. I mean, the patisseries. They're so good. Alright, well, this looks ridiculous right now. It looks like I have 4 hairs. Alright. I hope it turns out. That's all I can say. That's really all I can say. I just got a fucking idea. I'm not gonna tell anybody though. Hi, Hussie! Bonsoir! We are not cutting any more bangs! Cool gay bars are the best for straight folk? Yeah, you would think, but like, also, you know, it's like supposed to be a safe space for gay people, and the whole point of going to a gay bar is like, you can assume that if you're hitting on somebody and you're the same sex, or like the same, roughly the same gender-ish, because, you know, there's a lot of new genders out there. The idea is that you can hit on anybody there and it's gonna be okay, right? Like, that's why I love gay bars, because I'm like, oh, that girl's cute, I can hit on her because she's probably gay. Whereas at a regular bar, it's like, oh, that girl's cute, I'm gonna compliment her and she's probably gonna think I'm just being friendly, like, you know? So that's why it's like, straight people at gay bars, yes, if you are tipping, fuck yeah, go to a gay bar. But like, you know, it's not, do what you want to do. I feel like that's like kind of the energy that I've gotten from other people who like, are at the gay bars. Like, even going with my partner, so he is and again, this is not a derogatory term, this is just to describe him. He's a cis, hetero dude. So like, they're like, what are you doing here? You're not gay. And he's like, well, I'm with my partner who's non-binary. So like, you know? It's like, well, then you're at least a little bi, I don't know. Yeah, that's what I say. I'm like, you're at least a little bit gay if you're with me, because I hate to break it to you, but I am in fact a little bit trans. I'm a little bit of a trans baby. Kind of a dude, kind of a chick, kind of a not, either kind of a both. I don't even know. I didn't sign up for this. This is what I have. This is what I got. You're hit on by Xerophila. Somehow they just know. Yeah, well that's it. They just know. That's it. We got gaydars. They're joking about the gaydar, by the way. I have one too. I'm usually pretty spot on. And the few times that I've guessed and they've been like, oh, I'm not gay, it's like, oh, it turns out they're actually just like trans. Or they're just really closeted. Yeah, anyone that stands near me for an extended period of time is probably going to be clocked as at least a little bit queer. At least an ally. We would hope to see more allies, you know? I'm scared to know what the freaking, the preview looks like. You know when you go to browse Twitch and there's like a preview? And it's just me pulling my hair and putting dye in it, like a fool. So my roots aren't even really bleached right now, so it doesn't matter. Okay. You're not gonna catch the gay, don't worry. You're either born with it or you're not. But you might catch the confidence to come out. So that's the thing. I don't turn people gay, but if you're already gay, you just didn't realize it yet because of internalized homophobia and, like, religious guilt, then you might catch the gay. But the gay was within you all along. You had the power inside you. You just didn't know it. You know? Can I change the music? Actually, I don't know if you noticed, but my hands are covered in hair dye. So I can't. But if you would like to know about the music, it's actually me. It's my music, and I own all the rights to it because I wrote it, and I recorded it, and produced it. So that's why we were listening to it. And I would hazard to say that it is actually pretty good music. And I enjoy it, and I know my stream community does enjoy it too. You're married to a female with 4 kids and you're still not convinced you're straight. That's okay, you don't have to be. You can be a bi. You're allowed. Just because, so that's the thing, like, if you are a man and you're gay but you've never had sex with a man, that doesn't make you less gay. You know? Your orientation doesn't have to do with what your experience is, it's what your preference is. Right? So, if you're bisexual, you could have slept with 100 dudes and 0 women, but you're still bisexual because you're attracted to women, you know? It's about the attraction and the preference, my friends, not who you're married to. And I am very much... I'm like a lesbian, except for one man, apparently. Like, I'm very specific with dudes. They have to be super androgynous or, like, just perfect, apparently. I don't know. Actually, no, that's a lie. I'm not really that picky with dudes. I'm attracted to trash. That's been my past dating history. If you look at my previous dating history, it's literally just, like, look at a dumpster. Envision a dumpster. Now set that dumpster on fire. That's my dating experience, okay? That's my dating experience. But now I'm actually dating a 10, and I'm like, what the fuck? I don't know what to do with myself. It's weird. it's weird. He treats me nice and shit, and he cooks me food, and he always texts me, like, pretty much right away, and, like, gives me attention, and makes time for my feelings, and expresses his own feelings and concerns, and communicates. Like, what the fuck? Is this a relationship? Is this what it's supposed to be? You're kidding me. This can't possibly be what I've been missing out on for the past fucking 20-something years of my life. Well, I guess I didn't really start dating when I was a kid. I started dating in high school. The first person I dated is a trans man now, but they weren't back then. But that was like my first relationship. It was very queer. Kind of made sense. We were both just like closeted trans, except he was a trans man, or is a trans man, and I was a non-binary person. Interesting how that works out. Are you actually Michael? Don't fuck with me. Do not fuck with me in this chat. Because there's nothing wrong with being a virgin. The only thing wrong is joking about it. Because that implies that it's not okay to be a virgin. Because I did briefly, like, sort of date somebody. Like, dude, my single life, I don't think you're a virgin. I don't think so. You're a very attractive man. Okay, well, we don't need to, we can just leave that as a Schrodinger's virginity right now. You don't need to say it. But yeah, when I was single, I dated a lot of different peeps. Because I was just like, fuck it, like, no commitment, I'll just date whoever, like, you're attracted to me, great, take me out, let's go. I'm kind of into you too. You're interesting. You seem interesting. And then we go on a couple dates and I'm like, thank you. That was great. I'm not looking for anything. You wear a pretty ring? Okay, now I know you're joking. Because the only ring that you wear is a fucking Pokemon Go ring or something. I don't know. I would say you're bisexual. So bisexuality doesn't mean you're attracted to women and men. It's you're attracted to two or more genders. So you can be bisexual if you're attracted to women and non-binary people, but not men. Absolutely. Even if those non-binary people, so non-binary people can be AFAB or AMAB. You're in backsit, you know. That makes no sense. Thank you for the follow, by the way, Benj Animal. I didn't want to call you out because I know you're not typing in chat, but thanks for hanging out. We do play music on the stream primarily, as you can see by the giant records on the back and the piano that I spent $7,000 on, and the music that you're listening to, which is written by, and composed and performed by me. I'm a musician, but we're doing hair dye today, so welcome to the chaos. Hi, by the way. Hi, welcome. Alright, it's about to get real fucky up in here, okay? It is 7 o'clock, we have half an hour to finish the rest of this. Because I'm giving myself a half hour grace window, because my friend's getting here at 8, and he's always early. Because that's just how it goes. Look at that. Look at that! Look at that! Look at that! Look at that! Oh, fuck yeah, I'm gonna cum so hard. This hair is gonna be the best hair I've ever done. Okay. It's great because it's like, it's layered enough so it's thin. Oh man. I'm feeling a certain type of way. I need to chill out for a second. You never make a hair dye stream, so you're stoked. Well, frig yeah. And you paid for my internet on top of all of that. So today's a great day. Yeah, this is what the hair dye stream is. It's just literally chaos as I dabble paint into my hair and discuss with chat what they want me to do and then deny everything. It looks great already. Thank you. Yeah, we gotta get the front right. The front is the most important part. I don't care if I fuck up the back because I will never have to look at it. Alessandro will have to look at it. I don't have to look at it though. You guys probably will never have to see the back of my head. Brunch. Sometimes I take chat's advice, like, sometimes I'll go with it, but you guys usually don't have good ideas, no offense. You have terrible ideas. Dude, you literally, 2 seconds ago, you're like, shave a dick into your face! Do polka dots! Like, no! Those are terrible ideas. Get some good ideas, and maybe I'll do them. Fuck. Alright. No, I'm not gonna say that out loud. That's an intrusive thought. We don't say those out loud. I've been having a really hard time distinguishing between regular thoughts and intrusive thoughts lately because they've just been so loud. But we're gonna get back on the meds tomorrow. We're gonna get back on the meds and see how that does. See if that does any good. You know what I mean? Alright, this needs to... do a thing. Like, I don't know what it needs to do, but it needs to do a thing. Do I eat food? Yes! I eat... Oh my gosh, this is something else. I eat the limbs of my slain enemies and pasta. No. Today, so far, I've eaten gluten-free waffles with berry confit, like cherries, strawberries, raspberries, maple syrup, real Canadian maple syrup, mind you, like the good shit. And bacon and an omelet with mozzarella and onions and a little bit of almond milk just to give it that fluff. That was breakfast. And half an orange, which I was then interrupted halfway through because I had to get to my yoga class on time. Then I came back, finished that, and then I ate a poutine with pulled pork and bacon. Like, I'm like literally describing the most Canadian day. I'm like, yeah, I had waffles with real maple syrup, then I had a poutine. Fuck. And then I had a big thing of pasta. And then I haven't figured out dinner yet, but I'm like running through my meal prep. Dude, I've been to the gym. It's been a week I've been at this gym. And I'm like going through so much food. Poutine is, yeah, it's just like regular fries. Fries, yeah, like french fries with gravy and cheese curds. Gravy and cheese curds. It's a Canadian delicacy. Thank you, Timothy. Oh, I'm happy you like what you see. It's about to get real fucking crazy up in here. Oh my god. I'm so stupid. It's so stupid. It's like a little bird of paradise. You don't eat vegetable oil or wheat or meat or dairy. So what do you eat? Sunshine? I'm genuinely curious. You just eat sugar and vegetables? So like fruits and veggies? I've kind of been there, man. Or poor woman or non-binary pal. Potatoes, yeah. I've had a very restrictive diet because of my Crohn's disease when I was a kid. I went into remission, so I don't have Crohn's disease anymore, but I still have a lot of things that my stomach decides are not good. And I just kind of eat them anyways. Oh my god. Do you guys have the words memorized to my albums yet? I'm so scared. This is gonna be so uneven. Like, you guys have to help. Is it bad? I don't know. Yeah, cheese, for some reason, dairy fucks with me, but cheese and yogurt don't. Cheese and yogurt are fine. Because they're like bacterial pasteurized or some shit. Nobody's gonna notice if it's uneven, it's fine. We're just gonna do it. I don't care. Cheese and yogurt contain the enzymes properly needed to digest the... See, we have our nutritionist in the chat. Thank you, Jen. Thank you, Jen. That explains a lot of it. That really does explain it. Because I've been fine with frozen yogurt, but not ice cream. I'm fine with cheese. Cheese is really great for me, actually. I need cheese in my diet. Interesting. Alright, so now... Now we're gonna do something real crazy. Right? Oh my god, my forehead's so shiny right now because of the coconut oil. Oh my god. Okay. See, that's it. I said I was gonna put black in, but I didn't put any black streaks yet. But I'm like, what if I do? Ah, no. Oh, okay. Okay, I'm gonna start with what I had envisioned, which is this wrath. That was a good one. That peaked my microphone. That's how loud that was. Hot damn. Hot diggity damn. Yeah, sometimes you say fuck it, and then you're like, oh. You're like, why did I do this to myself? Oh my god. Yeah, I literally cannot eat if I eat a buffalo wing, I'm like, this is, like, when I'm eating it, I'm like, this is the best fucking thing I've ever fucking tasted. And it hits my stomach, and I'm like, oh no. And it hits my intestines, I'm like, oh god! And then I have to go to the bathroom, and it's just like, literally sobbing. The pain. Now, do I want to mix pink in with this? I don't know how I survive. I barely get by, honestly. Do I like that? I think so. Does it matter? Does it matter if I like it? I got bangs, bro. I just have to deal at this point. All right. Dude, this is not gonna be fun for the upkeep, though. I'm telling you right now. You drank a glass of chili sauce. Do you wanna die? Yeah, imposter syndrome is real. That's what the song is all about. Girls don't poop. Well, no, I think it's actually an issue of me being hot. So, hot bitches have tummy issues. It's just a fact. If a girl has tummy issues, it's likely because she's too hot. And so, life has to shoot her in the foot somehow. And so, the universe gives hot bitches tummy issues. It's just how it works, okay? Yeah, hot girls be shitting. Hot girls be at least two times a day. You know? That makes sense. Yeah, the math is mathing. The math is mathing. Yes, Ortica, we are going back to rainbows today. Welcome to the stream. I'm like trying not to make more wrinkles in my forehead. Which I'm pretty sure that was the body dysmorphia trigger that got me to make bangs in the first place. Is I'm like, I have forehead wrinkles now. Where? But like, I know some people in their fucking, they're literally 21 and they already have forehead wrinkles. So, I don't know. It's part of just living your life and having skin. You get wrinkles when you raise your eyebrows, right? But I don't know, man. The Botox craze that's going on is killing my self-esteem. I've never gotten any Botox, but like, fuck. It's so accessible now too, and it's like so normalized that I'm like, oh, shit, I'm next. But I don't know. I got thin lips, I got wrinkly skin, and I think I'm okay with it. Some days I judge myself, but, you know, I think I'd probably still judge myself if I got fillers anyways, so at least it's a little less expensive to judge my natural self. No judgment to those who do use, though, use Botox and fillers. Because I mentioned this before on my stream. I see it as a body mod. Like, I have tattoos. I would be a hypocrite. I have tattoos and colored hair and piercings. I'd be a hypocrite if I judge people for getting Botox. Because all it is you're just trying to make your physical self reflect your inner mind, right? You just want to modify your body so that you feel better about your body. So, you know? Yeah. Yeah, I feel like, though, like, I had this one trauma. I use natural pigments. Well, these are all vegan dyes. I don't know how natural they are, but they're vegan. So. I actually kind of like how this looks with some of the blonde bleeding through. You know? Might be cool to leave some of the blonde. You never smile because you don't want wrinkles? So that's I made a post recently on my Instagram. It was a reel and it said, each year I get new wrinkles, new chips in my teeth, but it's a gift that comes with aging because I never thought that I would make it this far. And seeing these wrinkles, I'm not looking at it as like, oh, gross, like, I'm ugly and I'm getting old. It's like, no, like, holy shit, I survived so much stuff. Each one of these lines on my face is from another crazy year of life that I've lived and made it through despite all the odds and despite my body being like, please don't, I don't want to live like this, you know? This color is actually really sick. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, that's what I'm saying. Or, like, I already have body dysmorphia. I think if I started messing around with fillers and injections and stuff, I, like, still would never be happy with myself. I just have to... You don't have to work on the physical... It's, like, it's what's in your mind that really is what matters, right? And I've gone through some crazy therapy sessions, and one of the therapy sessions we actually trace back to a trauma in my earlier child... Like, my early teen development. And we worked through that trauma, and it was, like... I shit you not, I looked in the mirror, like, a few days later, and my face changed. Like, I was looking at a stranger, like, I didn't recognize myself, because I looked, like, beautiful for the first time. Like, I was like, who is that person? And it's because I worked through that trauma, because I was made to feel really fucking ugly, and disgusting, and, like, scum of the earth when I was young. And so it's just, like, working through that helped me actually realize, like, holy shit, I'm beautiful. Like, on a physical level, I just, like, was like, oh, what? And it's crazy because I look at so many other streamers and I'm like, oh my god, they're so pretty. But I'm sure they think, you know, they have these, like, self-doubt thoughts. And they probably have moments where they're, like, not feeling themselves, you know? Thank you. Other streamers say the same shit about me. What? That I'm pretty? That I'm pretty? Well, that's it. Like, I actually started writing a song about that. By the way, thank you for the follow, Charlie Cheek. I started writing a song about that, and the chorus is literally just, I wish I could see me the way that you see me. That's all I have for the chorus, and I just kind of want to repeat that over and over and over. Because it means a different thing every time, right? It's like, I wish I could see me the way that you see me. Because some people see me in a way more positive light, but also some people judge me in a harsher light. And I don't know what other people are ever thinking, right? I never will know. It's so real, right? Like, my favorite is when you catch a stranger reading a book in public. Like, when a stranger is, like, just engrossed in a book in public, like, I'm like, that's their true self. They're just, like, engaged. They're not thinking about the outer world. They're just, like, I love that. And I always want to go up and ask them, like, oh, what are you reading? But, like, I'm like, no, they're in their zone. Like, don't. Oh, yeah, gushy, gushy. Looks like ketchup. Alright, we gotta speed this fucking process up. Holy shit. Alright, we're going in. We're going in with the hands. Going in with the hands. This is how I used to do it. Because, like, I would have, like, class at 8 and then a rave at 10. So I would just be like, alright. Give me that hair dye. If only that was possible, I think we'd be a lot kinder to ourselves, right? Yeah, but we spend too much time looking in our own mirrors and not other people's eyes. Also, not gonna lie, our phone cameras, way too high quality now. We can see every fucking pixel of our face. We're not meant to do that. Oh! A little nipple drip. What is your keyboard setting on today, Kagome? Or are you just drunk on a Sunday? No judgment. Nipple drip. Yeah, man. Nipple drip. It happens. I'm lactating. Actually, just I'm just blending it right in. Oh, you guys, the camera's a bit too high. There you go. You don't even notice. Easy. Easy peas. Licky, sticky, chop, chop, thick, little nip, knock, make it quicky, don't stop. Alright. So we get it back. It's okay, I didn't need this table to be clean anyways.
Alright.
Where is mine? Alright, this is gonna be great. I'm like not even doing an ombre, which is very unlike me, but it's gonna be great. Bye! Have a good one, Earth Tournament. Thank you so much for your tip. Thanks for paying the internet bill so I can keep streaming for all you beautiful people. I can't remember. So I'm definitely gonna stream music on Friday. I'll probably do a Discord hang Tuesday. I'm trying to do 3 streams a week. Like, that's like my goal. So this is like kind of stream 3 of the week. That's my goal, and it's realistic, because I also have, like, gigs, I'm trying to work out, I'm trying to meal prep, I'm trying to have a relationship, I'm trying to have a social life, I'm trying to foster cats, I have all these festival applications, and all this, like, music stuff I'm doing, too. It's a wild, wild world out here. Yeah, well, I did an 8-hour music stream on Friday. Where were you? Right? Okay, I actually might... I'm gonna fuck it up just a little. We're gonna fuck it up. Fuck it up. YOLO! YOLO? Radioactive, bitch. Oh my god, I got red in my hair on the spot. That's not supposed to be red. You're probably drinking. Come drink with me. That's the point. I think I started at 4 and I finished at like 11 p.m. Eastern. But, yeah, I want to get back to 2 music streams a week, but it's tricky because I've been renovating my studio and changing literally everything I know about myself. I'm going through my metamorphosis phase, okay? And discovering who I am again. I'm going through second puberty. It's been a lot because I'm on estrogen now and, like, it really does feel like second puberty for me. I'm going through a lot of changes, and it's like, you know, it's for medical reasons. Like, I've been having, and I have an ultrasound actually, Wednesday to figure out whether I might have, you know, some other underlying complications and stuff. I'm not gonna go into details, but that's why they put me on estrogen. So that I don't have chronic excruciating pain in my female genitalia reproductive organs, which I never really asked for in the first place, and I don't want them. But so we've been going through second puberty. It's a wild ride. It's a wild fucking ride. I feel like a different person. They didn't tell you that on the side effects. So like, side effects may include nausea, acne, and I'm like, what about complete identity crisis? Like, what the fuck? Because that's what I'm getting. It's giving identity crisis. But I just went through so many changes in such a short period of time that it's like, I just had to abandon the old me. I'm like, yeet. Get gone. See ya. Bye. It'd be like that sometimes. But that's it. Growth is necessary. That's part of being a human. You just gotta grow sometimes. Until you figure out what you're doing. And then you can just stick with that. I really admire people who have had it figured out. Like, they have a job they love. They're with a person they love. They've got, like, you know, stability in their life and their mind. And they know who they are. Like, how do you do that, man? I'm not there yet. Maybe I will be once I'm in my 30s. Maybe that'll be the time. Probably not, though. It'll probably take me way longer than that. I don't know. I feel like most of the people in my chat are what, like, probably in their 30s or older? We have some younger people, but... And even... I feel like a lot of people bring their kids to my streams, too. So we technically have some kid viewers, even though you're not supposed to be on Twitch, but... The active chatters are mostly... adults. You're 31. Yeah. Is it because we type so badly? No. You can type badly at any age. I don't think that's an age thing. But I still feel like we're youngins. Like, we're like the millennial kind of ish. Millennial? I think I'm still a millennial, right? 90s babies? For the most part. Wait, no, 36 would mean you're not a 90s baby. That means you're an 80s baby. You grew up as a teenager in the 90s. I don't know how that works. But you were around when Nintendo fucking came out, and that shit blew me away. Math. Am I right? Who needs it? Not me. Not this one. Scooch this chair. This is a hot mess. This is a hot fucking mess right here, what we're dealing with. Oh my god. I missed many spots. Listen, that's part of the deal. When you do it yourself, you're gonna miss some spots. It's fine. It's gonna be great. Okay, but what I wanted to do... It looks so good when I'm done. Yeah, because it just bleeds. Oh yeah, no, the big back part. I sectioned it off intentionally because I was gonna do something different with it. Light purple? No. I don't really do light colors because all of these colors are bold because they will fade to a light color eventually. Are you ready for this? Wait, no, that's the wrong one. Is actually not bright yellow. Like a bee? Oh, actually, that would be kind of cool. I wasn't expecting it to be that black. Like that, I used the tiniest bit and it just absorbed. Oh no. Oh no. Well, I'm definitely gonna wash my gloves now. I actually think it's gonna look really good. But I do need to go wash my gloves. Because I do not want black on any other part. And it's very... Okay, windows pop off. Okay, we'll be right back. I'm gonna run a quick ad. Can you guys hear me right now? You can hear me blow my nose?
Oh gosh.
I'm a little phlegmy. What can I say? Alright. It's crazy. The difference between the amount of mucus and saliva my body makes when I'm off my meds versus when I'm on my meds, it's like a desert. But honestly, I think I just need to quit vaping. That's gonna help a lot. Because it just flares up my asthma all the time. It is a banger, you are correct. See, now I have red spots, but it's because I dyed it. I still got this whole orange patch. A little orange cabbage patch over here. Miss the blonde. I'm not gonna lie. I think the blonde had its time. Usually I only go blonde for like 2 weeks and then I'm like, alright, back to rainbow. But I was going through some shit. Still going through some shit, but like less craziness. Okay. This back piece. What do I even do with it? What do I even do at this point? Pink? Well, because I want to do the stripies. When did that happen? Oh fuck, I missed a couple short pieces. I'm gonna have to go back in and get those. Cause that goes with that part. I missed some short pieces on this side too! Heck! Oh no. How did that even happen? Alright. Yo, what's up? Canceler. Welcome to the stream. Chaos is about to happen right before your very eyes. I'm gonna pin this up. I'll get back to these and match them, blend them in with the rest. But let's do the long pieces. We definitely are doing stripies. I just don't know. So M was saying bumblebee stripey. I think we do bumblebee stripey on this side and then we do a blue stripey on this side. Let's fucking get into it. Let's get into it, y'all. It's so hard though because there's so much hair. I'm actually gonna have to separate it into multiple sections. My hair's too thick. It's very thick with like 5 C's. I need to release new music. I think that's probably what we'll do this week, is because while I'm still figuring out my studio setup and all the instruments and stuff, I can still do music production at my computer. Because now my computer's set up. That was like the big thing, was like getting my entire fucking PC set up. The spaghetti of cable management, like the ultimate supreme spaghetti cables. Getting all of that into this room again. We did that. Now I gotta get all the instruments and stuff all back in here. That'll take some time too, but. Okay, Bumblebee. This is gonna be so high maintenance. Like, I swear, I'm gonna go swimming once and it's gonna fuck my whole hair up. I'm probably gonna skip out on the swimming for the first little bit, for the first wash. Otherwise, I'm gonna dive in the pool. Like, even with my swimming cap on, it still leaks. So I need a better swimming cap. But. Yeah. I cannot let the water touch this beautiful masterpiece. I can definitely do breaststroke, though. I'm sorry if you guys are getting sick of hearing the same songs over and over again. I promise I'm releasing new music at some point soon. Soon. The classic Merms. But if I did a covers album and like really went all in and like did hella banging cover versions, full produced, what songs would you guys want on those albums? I want to know. I think for me, I would have to do Take Me to Church, for sure. Like, that would have to be on there. Because Halsey just releases a new cover every week. I don't know how they do it. Like, they're literally super-powered humans. They grind so hard, and I envy them. Yeah, I can just pull my scalp right off my head. Wow. That's interesting. Look at that. Scalp. Something Lady Gaga. Yeah, but like, you know, that's almost too on the nose. Right? Like, what? Who knew you could do that? That's my scalp. If you just took a scalpel, you could literally scalp me. Is that a scalpel? Is that what they call it? That? Hi, Miguel. Thanks for the follow. Welcome. Peace of My Heart by Janis Joplin? Yes! Oh, good call. Because I don't think anybody else can sing Janis like I can sing Janis. I mean, they can sing it like they sing Janis, but not like I sing Janis. You know? Lizzo's been canceled. Ah, yes. The cancellation of Lizzo. Which I'm still like, I'm like, I don't like cancel culture. I don't want to be a part of it. But I also am a musician. And I'm also a victim of sexual assault. And I'm all of these things. And I'm like, I just feel conflicted. So I don't know what to feel at this point. You know what? Since the black stuck so well on that red, I'm just going to do the whole thing yellow. And then add the black in after. It'll probably work that way. Peace of My Heart. Take Me to Church. Some other song that I kill the cover of. Oh, heart-shaped box by Nirvana. I would want to do that. Radiohead. Why? Why is everybody so obsessed with Radiohead? Radiohead, but not Creep. No, but it would have to be Creep. That's what people know me for. It's my fucking weird-ass cover of Creep. I also do High and Dry, but I gotta learn more Radiohead. It's not enough. I don't do that one though. So it has to be songs that like I do regularly, you know, like songs that you would expect to hear me play at one of my shows, because those are the songs that I've played for so many years. I guess Zombie by the Cranberries would be like another one of those that I've done so many times for so many years. But like, that's it. I always try to pay tribute to Dolores. I don't try to make it my own. I just like try to embody her as much as I can. But if I were to actually make that song into my own version of it, you know, who knows what I would do with it, because it's a beautiful loop. It's a beautiful four chord song. So. All right, on this side, we were gonna go with the pastel. Hold up, got my back mirror. This needs to be on this side. Oh my God. So, where did you sleep last night? You like that one? Oh, cause I get really raspy with that. But I like Heart-Shaped Box way more as a song. Cause where did you sleep last night? That's not even Nirvana's song. They covered a cover. Ariana Grande covers? We already, listen girl, we did that. We did do an Ariana Grande cover. We did Positions. Because the thing is, I wouldn't want to do a covers album where I put out this album and it's like, oh wow, you sound exactly like the original. Like, I want it to be better than the original. So I want to put my own spin on it, you know what I mean? And a little twist of it, you know? Valerie is also a cover of a cover, because Amy Winehouse, right? So that would be it. A whole fucking crapshoot. But I'm out of brushes. Are you serious? Oh no, I have one. Okay. Bob Dylan? I don't know that one though. So I'm thinking more like songs that are near and dear to me, that I've been playing for all these years. Oh, maybe Four Non Blondes? That's like one of my go-tos at the bar, because I will rock the shit out of it no matter what. This is supposed to be like a pastel blue, but it's giving gray. Yeah. Yeah, like do 4 a.m. Do what's up, but give it like a. I know I texted him on my break while I was horking up my loogie and going pee. I don't know if you guys can hear me pee too. Fuck, this mic picks up everything. I texted him and be like, hey, maybe give me like an extra 15 minutes buffer time. I'm running behind schedule. But he's a very understanding friend. He's very patient. He knows that I have ADHD, as they say. And I also wasn't expecting him until 9. He's like, actually, I can make it earlier. I can be there for 8. And I'm like, okay, that's great. Fully thinking that I would be ready. Haha. Joke's on me. I am a fool. Okay, so this did really nothing to my hair. Except tone it. Maybe this is supposed to be a toner. Okay, would not recommend. I think this is just a toner, straight up. It looks like this. Like, I'm like, oh, it's gonna look like pastel seafoam green. But no, it's just a toner. Just a little toner. Okay. So got that. I can go in now. Make sure I got the back too. Prince, oh, the kiss, yeah. Oh, no, here's a bitch, to be my girl. See, cause that would be a great album, cause like I'm paying tribute to the greats, right? I mean, technically, like, Valerie wasn't even Amy Winehouse, but like that's what she's so known for, and that's what like everybody knows that song, so it would be a good one. Kissed by Prince, Valerie, as Amy Winehouse. Heart Shaped Box by Nirvana, Peace of My Heart by Janis Joplin. Zombie by the Cranberries. Four Non Blondes, What's Up? And, I mean, Take Me to Church is just more like a modern, like it's definitely modern, but... But just to add like a decade to it. I think that hits a lot of decades, doesn't it? Maybe even like might come together by the Beatles, but I don't know. That song is just so fun. I'm running out of room. I'm making a mess. I have stuff all over my stuff. And I'm running out of time. So let's get these stripies going in the hair. I need one more brush. Fall Out Boy? Oh my god. I mean, I love Fall Out Boy, but they'd be hard to cover. I wouldn't even know where to begin. I'd probably be more likely to cover a Panic at the Disco song. Death of a Bachelor? Like, my... Because I take it up half an octave so that it's in my range. Death of a Bachelor could be the move. That song's iconic. It's actually stupid good. Okay, this is gonna be nuts. At least it's like wet now, so it'll be easier to kind of align. I'm just like fucking up this shirt. This is an old shirt. It's gonna. See where we're going with this? This is the era of I don't give a shit. This is the scene mullet that we all wanted back in 2007. Easy as that. Other side? Less is more, people. Less is more. Yeah, this black dye is fucking atrociously black. All right. We made it this far. We can make it through anything. I do need to finish up the back sections that I missed, that I clipped. There's a room sign now, right? Not some weird platinum blonde bimbo. Okay. Now I just gotta get these pieces. Pieces of people. And now I can make my Montreal debut and people are gonna actually recognize me and I'll be like, what? You're blonde. I thought, what happened to the rainbow hair? Like, I tried being normal. It didn't really work out. I did a trial run. I unsubscribed after the free trial period, you know. Oh god, I'm so hungry. Is this what going to the gym regularly does to you? You just like are hungry all the fucking time? Now I gotta think about food. My friend's coming over, I gotta think about food, I gotta think about cleaning. There's so much to do! Why do I always have so much to do? It never ends. When do I just get to go on a vacation and just not do anything for like a month? At that point, I will want to do stuff again. I'll be like, okay, I'm bored. Take me back. I want to work hard. I feel useless. It's Sunday at like 8 p.m. I'm gonna have to cook myself food. To cook, I'll probably just make ramen. I said I was gonna make ramen the other day and I never did, so Maybe I will make a ramen. Yikes, my dude. Oh my fuck. What in the... What's going on here? What's going on? What's going on? You guys get to see all that. I'm like contortioning my body so I can figure this shit out. Alright, let's go red. A little bit of reddy red. Oh my goodness. That is such a huge spot that I missed. Need more red. Oh, nose is itchy, but to come out scratch. Okay. God, we're getting there. How are we holding up chat? Okay. The insanity has fully set in. We are living the dream. I'm actually really stoked at how the red holding strong. Hell yeah. Thanks for being here with me this whole time. While I go through this very delicate process of reinventing myself for the 17,000th time. I honestly should have kept track of how many times I've dyed my hair, but at this point it's like infinite. I actually love those little black streakies. They're cute. They can stay. They can party with us. We get messy. And then we clean it all up. I have so much cleaning to do today. Literally, like, it's gonna be a shit show. Probably spend tomorrow cleaning, too. To be honest, maybe that'll be... Usually Sunday's my cleaning day, but I also had to dye my hair today because I just had to. And tomorrow I have a personal trainer session. So I'm back at the gym again. Look at me go. Always be gymming. This is exactly what Helena Bonham Carter does when Tim Burton calls and says they're gonna be... Isn't he married to her? Wouldn't he just wake up in bed and be like, sweetie, I came up with a new idea in my sleep last night. She's like, oh, well, darling, okay. Oh, I see, darling. Oh, I guess I'll put on my best bustier. I'll be off. And powder my face, I'll make sure to stay out of the sunlight. Alright. They lived in separate houses while they were together?
Oh no, I understand separate rooms, but separate houses? Entirely? I mean, I guess. Like, I'm kind of grateful that me and my partner have our own spaces so we can be away from each other sometimes. Because we do our own things, have our own lives. But if you're, like, married to someone, it's weird. A little bit weird. Must suck being that rich. Yeah, right? I thought the whole point of marrying someone was so you can afford to have a house. Because if you combine your incomes, you might be able to afford property! Oh! Spicy. Alright. Let's see. We still got a little tiny, tiny little bit of black. Little bit of black. Just a tiny little bit. That's a very fun fact. I'm so glad you shared that with me. It's said famously living next door to one another in London Belize Park, Belsize Park. Connected by a hallway. Snoring was an element of their housing situation. I can relate. No tea, no shade, but I cannot stand when people snore. Like, it drives me nuts, dude. It drives me nuts! My foster parents are so fucking perfect for each other because my foster dad is deaf and my foster mom snores so loud. But so my foster dad just takes out his ear, what do you call them, earpieces? Hearing device? He just takes them out at night and she snores like a freaking tractor beam, and he just can't hear, and they're perfect for each other. I love them so much. Hearing aids, that's the word. My brain just couldn't think of aids. I get why. My brain's just like, that is a blocked term, you're not allowed to say that word. All right, we're done. Did I miss any spots? I swear to God. We have what is this? What are you? Are you left or right? I can't. Are you LGB or T? At this point, I don't even know. We're just gonna. It's like all the colors, man. We're just gonna put a red, because I have a red on my hands already. Red! It's probably wrong. It's supposed to be left, but it's fine. It's my hair. I don't care. Yeah, cut it off. We'll never speak of this again. We are done. Yo, this is gonna look like the perfect scene mullet. You guys, I'm gonna be back with a vengeance in the just chatting section. Probably on Tuesday. Which makes me think, I'm like, actually, fuck, maybe I can't go swimming with Jen Jen. Maybe I can follow you on your fitness stuff, though. Teach me how to lift weights and shit. Or actually, I'll probably know how to do that because I have my personal training session tomorrow. I don't know. Gym 3 days in a row? Could it be? I literally need a new obsession. Because otherwise I will just... Well, I get one free session with my gym membership sign up. So, most gyms do that. We can do weights. go for the baby weights, though, because I don't want to break myself. Because Wednesday I have a date night and an ultrasound, so. But the ultrasound is not going to be on my biceps, so I should be okay. All right. I have to head out. I'm not sure who to raid, and I don't particularly have time to do that, searching for raiding people. So I'm just going to do one of the old-fashioned Irish goodbyes. I think that's what they call it. And I'm going to give you guys one of these. And Kagome, if you want to raid, by all means. By all means. I will see you guys later, caterers. And join the Discord if you haven't already, but there's not that many new people here. But if you are watching and you're new here, slap that follow button. Why not? I'm a fucking weirdo, and I'm pretty interesting if you get to know me. So I will see you around. See you on Tuesday. Bye. Have a good night. Take care.